Alright, everyone. It's your boy PTP for the week, aka Dumbass Jets Fan of the Week. You called it right here, FTP. You called it right here, 49ers Nation. Shit, I'm eating my words on a straight my words diet. I was talking a lot of shit coming into the week. My boys really made me look like a clown. Ooh, I'm still sore from the ass kicking we took that week. I mean, I looked for one. I couldn't find one key play on offense. Where was the key play? Where was what could we draw from this game offensively? The only thing I drew from this game offensively was zero, a big zero. You guys shut us the. I'm not even gonna cuss. You guys just shut us out. We're not even. It speaks for itself. 0 points. Oh. Nothing worked. I mean, I didn't even want to go through it. Like when I was really sitting down looking for that one guy who really performed offensively, who Chaz Schilling, 3 catches, 45 yards. I mean, Santonio Holmes had a couple big plays, but he got hurt. Where do we go from here, man? Where do we go from here? This is 3 straight weeks. We haven't looked great. And I really thought we were going to bounce back from last week. That I really did. I mean, this is where I come off. You know what? Eating my words. I mean, put my foot in my mouth there. Because basically, I thought we were going to be the two teams. Of the two teams that didn't play too well last week, both of us. I mean, you guys lost and we scraped by last week. I really thought being at home, we'd come out, we'd respond, we'd perform better. But I was wrong. Utter regression offensively. I mean, you guys played great defensively. I'm not taking anything away from you, but I think 49 cents. In 49 cents video, Deion Sanders said it best. When you asked him, were the 49ers playing great or were the Jets playing really bad? And he said both. Both. Because we were hella bad. The defense was alright for a bit, but then we got worn down and it was Swiss cheese. You look at the numbers. I thought we were going to stop you on the ground. Wrong. Wrong again. Wow, you guys warned me about Kendall Hunter. But none of y'all told me about Colin Kaepernick. Shit. And I mean, I'm here saying Tebow is going to be the X factor, and this guy comes out here and changes the game, or at least puts you guys up early. Because, like I said, zero speaks for itself. You guys could have scored 1 point, and we weren't going to win this game on some CFL shit. I really don't know what to say. I have to say, hey, shout outs to 49ers Nation. Shout out to King FTP. I owe you a hat. It's coming. Hit me up in the inbox. We'll figure that shit out. I'm a man of my word. I'm gonna get your hat. And just, yo, 49ers Nation, I gotta take the shit I said back about you guys being overrated. You came in here, kicked our ass, dominated Jim Harbaugh. I mean, all the credit in the world to him. What a game plan he came out with. Like I said, the Colin Kaepernick shit was really creative. And just the way he utilized Alex Smith, I thought was really effective. Really kept him out of trouble. Limited the throws and limited the right situations to throw the ball. So, props to him. Props to Alex Smith. I was really saying he was gonna turn the ball over and give our team some opportunities. He didn't do that. You guys are giving us some hate on him because he overthrew Manningham on some of those plays. I mean. I think you guys are just really looking for that one thing to nitpick. We were looking for that one thing to be was wrong with this game. Nah, man. We had a little bit of pressure there. I mean, Alex Smith in general, he looked good. Even some of those Manningham plays, I really think those were more Alex Smith. He really did throw some good balls in there. So I'm eating my crow on that one as well, too. And now... What still haunts me is the zero. I'm going to keep coming back to the zero throughout this video because it really says something. I mean, I'm not even going to talk too much about your defense because, like, 0 points. You guys didn't even give up a field goal. And I want to straight up say you guys dominated us in basically every aspect of the game except for field goal kicking. And that's probably because we didn't even kick a field goal. I mean, Sanchez came out in the press conference and said, you know what, he took the blame, said he played bad. Which, I mean, I guess everyone can kind of see that. So that was pretty obvious that he needs to improve his play. On a side note, Jets fans, what I took a little bit of offense to was he didn't really want to claim that interception on the screen pass, saying that it was just kind of a lucky thing that could happen, which I agree, it is a lucky thing that could happen, but I mean, in this situation, you really got to come up, step up, own up to that. We can't have that happen. But I mean, that aside, Sanchez then said that, you know, on the two plays where our receivers got injured on the ball, we had a chance to get at least a field goal. Wrong again. The way this game went, we were meant to score no points. I am almost certain that the way things went that game, that if Nick Folk went out there, we were going to miss it. I mean, Akers was already missing field goals. And, I mean, I can't say anything that was really going right for us. So, I just got to say, if we play anywhere near how we played last week, Houston is going to embarrass us next week. I mean, I'm not going to come here and disrespect the 49ers fans to say Houston Texans or San Francisco 49ers, you know what I mean? But I'm going to say they're a similar team, they have a similar style, and we didn't look good at all. I mean, we did not look good at all. And this is coming from a guy that had high expectations. This is really what's really disappointing. I mean, I understand the San Francisco defense. I guess I did underestimate you guys, but not this bad. Not this bad. There definitely needs to be some improvement. Even the Tebow shit, you guys have that generally shut down too. I'm not even gonna come down here. Really, all I can say is we need to step up. The Santonio Holmes injury is gonna be a real. That, what to say after that? Our receivers are already not looking deep. Stephen Hill is out. I hear Keller's coming back, but with no Holmes, I don't know how we move on from here. The MRI was negative. It's not a pulled Achilles, so those are two pluses. But what is it? Because he looked like he was in a lot of pain when that happened, so I don't know what the next step is. Now, Jets fans, like I said, I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. Was I the only one out here that really believed in these guys? And what do you guys think about Texans? Like, this is Monday night. I mean, we come out and throw another stinker out there like this, and that's embarrassment. So, once again, props to 49ers fans. Props to King FTP. You called it Dumbass Jets Fan of the Week. Hopefully I'm better next week. I'll see you guys on the flip side. Great hate week. I'm out.